Assessment, grading, feedback. So, as a teacher, we have to teach, teach, and we have to mold the students. So, we have to make the teaching learning process more efficiently. And after our teaching learning process, we should assess the students, right? We should assess the students as well as we can judge our teaching also. Yes. So in teaching components, teaching is essential, learning is also essential. So after teaching learning process, as a teacher, we should assess the students, right? So Rajkumar sir, screen is visible?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, visible, sir.
So nowadays, we have to assess our students. So many technological tools are there in teaching learning process. Similarly, there are assessment tools are there for assessing our students. For example, formative evaluation, summative evaluation, right? So for formative assessment or formative evaluation, we are using some digital platform like many tools. Let me introduce the tools. Okay. So based on our assessment, we can give a grading for students and also we can provide feedback for the students. Okay. So these are some online assessment tools.
Sneha madam, excuse me sir. Sneha madam, Kennedy sir, Judith Jalaja, and Selva Kumari madam, please mute your mic, ma'am. Sir, please proceed.
Okay, snapshot also. Okay, so these are the, some online assessment tools. See here, Quizzes, Kahoot, Socrative, Google Quiz. These are the, some essential online tools for assessment of students. Okay, now let me focus on Quizzes and this Zoom Meet. Okay, so in this Zoom Meet, I am focusing on Quizzes.com. Right.
So,
so normally in classroom learning, the teacher should be very facilitator for our students' learning, and also we can make the students joy and fun. Okay, we can make the students joy and fun because this is the quarantine time. Okay, so in this quarantine time also the teacher job is very challenging. We can make the students to participate in teaching learning process. So we are all separated by distance. So in this time also the teacher make the students interactive in learning. For example, there may be learning, so we can make the students performance. Okay, so for this you can conduct a quiz program for online. We can call this EQs, right? So in this online platform, we can make the students joy and fun. Let me go for next slide. Yes, this is assessment tool, quizzes.com. So this is the platform I am going to discuss today, quizzes.com. Okay, so in this quizzes.com, so you see here, engage everyone everywhere. Okay, so wherever the students are, there is no problem, there is not at all a problem. So we can make the students to participate in their home itself. So from the comfort zone, they can participate in the online quiz. So for this, the Quizzes website is having a wonderful platform for assessing our students. So using Quizzes for distance learning, so I already told students always see the questions on their own screen. So for
yes,
Rajkumar sir, somebody is waiting in a waiting room. Please make them
out. Okay.
So in the Quizzes platform, you can see several subjects. Okay. English and language arts, mathematics, social studies, science, many disciplines are there. Okay. So for assessing the tools, we no need to create never create another worksheet. Okay. So the website will create a worksheet for our students' results. Okay. So I will tell one by one. And students engage at their own pace, okay, based on the students fast learners, slow learners, and average learners. So based on their pace of learning, they can attend the course, and based on the results, we can give you a feedback. So create a quiz. Now let me give you a demo how to create a quiz in this eQuizzes platform. Okay. Yes. Let me go for Google Chrome. Yes, go to Google page. Just type quizzes.com. quizzes.com. So this is the website. So in this quizzes.com platform, we can create a e-quiz. Okay. Yes, so this is the home page. Just go to Google and type quizzes.com. Okay, quizzes.com, quizzes.com. So this is the home page. Here you can see the students are very active. They are very fun, right? They are very fun. So they are engaged in the learning by using a mobile tools and a iPad. Okay, so we can make the students more fun and more enjoyable by using this quizzes.com. So you see here, engage everywhere, everyone and everywhere. So first, as a teacher, we have to create a new account at eQuizzes.com. For example, get started. See here, get started. Better I go for a highlighter pen. Okay. So get started. Okay. So you just click get started. So you have to create an account for your eQuizzes.com. Now it will ask sign up. Okay, it will ask sign up. Everyone is having Gmail account, so no need to go for this second option. You just sign up with Google. Okay. Yes. So it will ask our Gmail account. Okay. Let me click my Gmail ID. By using this Gmail ID, the account will be open. Okay, so it will take to the quizzes.com homepage, right? Yes. So this is the homepage. So by using this my Gmail account, I have created quizzes.com. See here, this is the homepage. You can find create a new quiz, find quiz, my quizzes, reports, classes, collections, memes, and this is the homepage. Okay. These are the quizzes created by other teachers. They have created the quiz and posted in the eQuizzes.com. So we can find similar type of quizzes based on our subject. Okay, based on our subject. See here, there are several quizzes: English language arts, social studies, world languages, science, computer science, skills, career and technical education, creative arts, health and physical education. So in each and every subject, the teachers are creating e-quizzes and they are hosting, they are sharing in this e-quizzes platform. By using this created quiz, we can conduct a quiz. Otherwise, our own subject, we can create a new quiz on our subject for our students. Okay. For example, let me create a new quiz for our subject. For example, I just take it as a general knowledge questions. So since there are several disciplines are there, so I just make it as a general knowledge quiz. Okay. So first, create a new quiz. Okay. Create a new quiz. You can create a new quiz option. So if you click this option, you will find the window like create a quiz. So you can name this quiz. Okay. You can name this. For example, I am going to create a general knowledge quiz. Okay. I am going to create a general knowledge quiz. So I enter here. General knowledge quiz. Okay. And you can choose relevant subjects. For example, in physics subject, you are creating a quiz means you can select physics or even chemistry, biology. So based on the subject, you can select the subject here. So you can find and categorize the subject related to quiz. So for this option, you can select. So I am creating general knowledge quiz. So I go for more option. So there is no general knowledge here. So I click other option. Okay, other option. And I click next. Okay, I click next. Yeah, it will take to the window like this, right? Yeah, you can see here, quiz editor option, quiz editor. Now you are the editor. You are making a quiz. You are creating a quiz, right? Here you can find many types of choices. Here, new question option. There is a new question option. As participants, can you follow me? Okay. Right. So this is a new question. Okay. You just click this new question. Okay. Click new question. Okay, so you have to add first question. So if you click this new questions, you can find many options. Okay, like multiple choice, checkbox, fill in the blank, poll, open-ended. So these are the many features we can adapt in your quiz. Right, first of all, let me select multiple choice question. Okay, just click a new question and multiple choice question. Okay, right. So you can see the window like this. If you click the multiple choice question, you can see write your questions here. Right, write your questions here. Okay, so already you can create some questions for inserting for uploading this quiz platform. I have created some questions in GK. Right, questions. So I have already created. Yes, general knowledge questions. Participants, can you follow me? Can you see the screen? Rajkumar sir? Okay, right. So I have created some questions, right? Here I can copy this question. Yes, copy and go to business platform. Yes, just paste. So which state is going to observe no weekend day on the first day of every month in 2020? So this state is part. This is the question, general knowledge question. Okay. Now you have to add options. Multiple for creating multiple choice questions, there are four choices. Okay. Kerala, Gujarat, there is an option. So you can add options, Kerala, Gujarat. Delhi, okay, and Rajasthan. So there are four options. There are four options. If you want to add one more option, here you can see add one add another option, add answer option. Okay, add another one answer option. Suppose if you click here, it will come. So if no need, you just delete this option. Okay. So for generally, multiple choice are having only four choices. Okay. So we can give four options. So this is the way we can create a single question. So I have created a question. I have given a four options. Right. Now I want to add a picture regarding this quiz. For example, which state is going to observe a vehicle day? We can make the students more interesting. So we can insert some picture regarding this question. Right. See here. Add image or audio. Okay. Image. You can add image or audio option. Now, I want to add some image regarding this question. Click this question, add image, and you can find. Okay. So just drag and drop the picture from your device. Okay. So already I have created some pictures. Okay. And questions images I have created already. Okay, I have created already. For no vehicle, I think no question is a no vehicle. Okay, so I have inserted a no vehicle image from Google. So already created. You just and open it. See here, the image is uploaded. Okay, the image is uploaded. So which state is going to observe no vehicle day on this first day of every month in 2020? So there are four options. So regarding this question, I have added picture also. Okay, if you add picture, we can make the students very interesting to attend this quiz. And finally, we submit save option. Another one important thing is, we have to select the right answers. Okay, as a teacher, we are creating quiz, so we know the answer, right? So just click right answer, Rajasthan. So after attending this quiz, students can see the right option. Students can see the right option after attending the quiz. So as a teacher, while framing the questions, we can add the right answer as tick mark, and we can save this question. Yeah. So successfully we have created one question. Okay. Similarly, we have to add n number of questions. Right. For example. I want to add another question. Okay, for demo purpose, I am adding another question. See here, multiple choice questions. Right. So I have India's first ever national police mission will be established in which city? So there is a plan. So this is a question. Okay. So I copy the question and paste it here. Chennai, Delhi, Nagpur. These are the options. Sorry. Once you know the answer, you can type it. Kolkata. So I have given four options. Okay, which is the correct one? Delhi. Okay, so I can click Delhi. Now I want to add picture. Okay. This one I have already installed from. I have already downloaded from Google page. Okay, Google image. So if you make ready the questions with answer with pictures, you can fastly make the questions. So finally, we add question, we add options, and you can insert a picture. You can see the display here. See here. So the students can see the display in their mobile phone or laptop like this. Okay? I have created a question like this. See here. See the screen. Screen will be very attractive. Question with the picture, and there will be four choices, right? Finally, I just click save options. Okay, right. Okay. So similarly, you can add any number of questions. Okay. For example, you want to add open-ended questions, right? Checkbox, you can see the checkbox options, fill in the blank hole, and open-ended questions. Suppose you are creating a questions without, you know, choices. Okay, there is a open-ended questions. Just I am asking. Okay. Or you can ask the questions to students. Sir. Okay. How do you spend it? Where? Okay, there is options and you can save it. So there will be no choices. Okay, this is open-ended questions. So students will be responded on their own. The answer will be saved in the SQSS website. Okay, finally you can get it, right? And you can save the questions. So similarly, you can create multiple choice, fill in the blanks or poll or open-ended questions. Okay, so this is the way you can create the questions. Now, there may be a doubt. For example, see here, the second question, in question 2, okay, you have wrongly typed or you have wrongly entered the answers. Suppose you want to edit, here you can find the edit option. Okay, you can find the edit option and click edit. See here. So again, the screen will like this. So you can, suppose, first ever, I have added correction. Okay. Some, there is any correction you can add. You want to delete the picture, you can delete here. For edit options, you can. So again, you can save it. Right. Suppose you no need to have this question, you can delete this question here itself. If you want to delete the third question, you can delete here itself after adding. Okay, and especially you want to delete the question, so there is an option delete here. Okay, and you can duplicate. You can copy this question. Okay, you can copy the same questions. Suppose when there is citation needed, you can copy this question, or you can change the options in boxes. Right. Okay. So after completing, I created for demo purpose 3 questions. Okay. You can create, depends upon your subject. For example, you can create 20 questions, 30 questions, 30 questions and 50 questions. Okay. You can create many number of questions. So after creating these questions, you just click done options. Don't forget, this is the final stage of this creating a quiz. Done options. See, right corner, you can see the done options. Okay. So just let me click the done option. Yeah. So you can see the quiz details. So for this creating a quiz, you can add picture, right? Add picture. For example, this picture, I just am adding a picture. So already I have some pictures. So I used to add this picture. Click open. So you can find it here, right? Second option, select language. There are many languages out there. So I can select English language, and see here, third option, select grades, okay. See here, KG. So grading start from KG to standard, KG to plus 2, university, professional development. So KG to professional development, as a teacher, professor, we can conduct this, or we can conduct this for students, and you can please conduct this for professionals. Okay. So for example, GK, you can select any, depends upon our students. Okay. I select university. Okay. So select Grace University. Suppose if you wish to create a quiz for your UG graduates or school students, you can select the KGR, first standard, second standard, third standard. For third standard subject, you can create for English or science. Okay. Now I just make it as university, and fourth essential option is who can see this piece. Here there are two options: public, visible to everyone. Okay, public, visible to everyone. Suppose if I select this option, public, visible to everyone, anyone can access this question. Anyone can access, anyone can go to quizzes.com, can find the general knowledge option. It will be visible. Okay. Suppose I am creating this quiz on my own. Just private visible to you. There is another option. See here, private visible to you. Okay. Private visible to you. Okay. So if you select this option, no one can access this, access your questions framed by you. Okay. Suppose if you are creating a quiz, you have to maintain it confidential because you are going to organize this quiz competition or quizzes for students. Okay. So students should not see the questions. For that purpose, you can select private visible to you, and finally you just save it. Yeah. Ready? The questions are ready. Yes, the questions are ready. Just I have read three questions. Questions are ready. Now you can find that there are three options: play live, assign homework, practice. Play live, assign homework, practice. Okay. Normally we can go for play live. For synchronous mode, you know the synchronous. So people are sitting in a same time. So this is synchronous. Okay. There is another asynchronous. Okay. So in this synchronous mode, people are joining together at a time. We can conduct a quiz. Right. This is play live. And assign homework. We can assign homework for students. Particular time, we can give these questions for asynchronous mode. We can give assign practice. And solo practice. The same questions can be attended by individual students with their own time and own choice. This is a party substance. Okay. Now you can go for. Let me go fastly. So please, there is, I think, 3 minutes more in this Zoom link. Okay. So please, participants, after the link is over, please click the same link and join again. Okay. Within 2 minutes, let me conclude this one. Right. Play live option. Play live. Okay. Play live options. We can see the window like this. General knowledge quiz. Okay. We have created three questions. General knowledge quiz. Right. This is the subject, and this is these are the questions. Now, so three questions. You can click here. Okay. So before go to continue, you see the options like see here. Assign to class. Okay, not assigned to any classes. We are not assigning. We are going to organize a quiz, so we don't want to assign the class. See the advanced settings options. See the advanced setting options. General settings. Student attempts. Here, how many times can students take this quiz? Unlimited. Okay. Actually, we have to select one time. So one time only each student has to participate. So if you select this option, for example, the quizzes.com, they have to log in. Okay. Login. Okay. Yes. Now I selected unlimited because so if you, I am for the demo purpose, you no need to log in. Okay. So simply I just selected for demo purpose unlimited. Okay. I will close the quiz. Okay. I won't allow you to attempt a second time. I will close the quiz. So I just unlimited. Name factory. Students can only use fun quizzes generated names. Fun quizzes generated names. For example. For now, students can use fun. Sometimes my name is Thangavel. Okay, so I can name it as Thangavel. Okay, suppose I select this option, the quizzes.com will generate a name for you. Okay, you can select that name. This will make the students funny. Okay, so now no need, right? So answers in game. So students in the correct answers after each questions. So after attending the questions, they can see the correct answer. Suppose they commit wrongly, they can view the correct answers. So we can enable this option and show answers post game. Allow students to review questions and answer at the end. Okay. So after attending all the questions, they can review the questions. For example, you have created 10 questions or 20 questions. After attending the quiz, they can review. So whether it is which question has wrongly attended, which questions has wrongly correctly attended or wrongly attempted, so you can, the students can review the questions. So there is an option called show answers post game. Okay, so just I make this option enable. Okay, right. And power up options. Power up. This is the lastly we have applied quizzes.com. This is the final score of the participants, right? So this is the way we can organize or conduct this program. Okay. As a participant, a participator. So you see, just imagine that as a teacher, I hope you have to conduct a quiz, right? You have to create a quiz. You have to create a quiz on your own. This will be the today's assignment. For 30 participants have participated. Okay, I should know the Excel sheet. The Excel sheet, the names are here. So I will take it as attendance, right? Attendance. So I have attendance. Only 34 participants have participated. 30 participants. Okay. So this is what I said. I have got attendance. Once you played, I have got your name. Right. So last, let me conclude. So in this quizzes platform, so you can organize a quiz, or you can create a quiz. You can find a quiz on your subject. Someone has created. Okay, my quizzes. If you created your quizzes, you can go for the my quizzes. So. Just Gmail account, you will have all account. You will have all pieces on your Gmail, on your account. Okay, for number of years, you can have these pieces. Okay, no need to delete. You can organize for next year or for after 2 years, you can organize. Right? So it will be saved in your account only. It will not be deleted once unless you delete the piece. Okay. Right. And let me go for PowerPoint presentation last at the end.
Class circle.
Raju, sir, can you see my PowerPoint presentation?
No, sir.
Again, I go for screen sharing.
Sorry, so squeeze its page.
Wait a minute. How is it visible?
Yeah, your PowerPoint is visible.
Okay. See here, let me conclude, okay? So you can create a quiz in your subject. Okay? As a teacher, you can create an old subject, basics, chemistry, botany, zoology, or English, mathematics, any subject you can create. Or you can use a default quiz in quizzes.com, okay? So you can go for the quizzes.com. No need, suppose if you want to, no need to create. If you don't want to create, you can use the other quiz, right? Other is option, and you can conduct the online quiz competition. Like in the quarantine, you can organize a quiz, online quiz competition for state level, national level. Okay, so for using this platform, you can organize this national level quiz competition. And no, don't worry about wherever the students are. Okay, students may be placed in their comfort zone of their house. Okay, so you can, and this quizzes platform will integrate all the participants in one place. Okay, already we have seen. Right, so like I think many participants from North India. Okay. We hope all participants have connected together to organize this quiz program. So similarly, you can conduct organize a quiz like this. The overall results will be graded by the website. Okay, I have demonstrated now. So overall, will be downloaded by the Excel sheet. So the Excel sheet, the quiz app will be evaluated and it will be graded like one, first, second, third, fourth, right? And you can get the overall results within 3 seconds. We can share the students' results to parents also. Okay, after the result page, we can see the email to parents. In that options, we can share the students' results to the parents. So this is the quizzes.com. So there is another option, mobile app. You can download the same quizzes from mobile, Google Play Store. Okay, Google Play Store, you can download the mobile app also. Okay. So this is the main thing I want to share in this session. The next slide. Did you smile today? So for attending this quiz, Now it's a time for questions, discussion. If you have any doubt, you can ask me.
Participants, please ask your doubts.
Please mute yourself and please unmute yourself and ask me question if you have any doubts regarding this piece. So this is the very interesting digital online platform for conducting formative assessment for our students. Okay. This is we can make the students more fun, enjoyable, and more interesting later activities. For any subject, we can organize this piece. And the main thing is, the main essential thing in thispieces.com, if we organize these pieces, online pieces in this platform, if there is any network cut means, if there is network failure means, it will continue automatically. Where you have stopped, it will continue automatically. In Kahoot or any other, for example, Discourse, Kahoot or Socrative, if it is cut means, you have to start from beginning. Okay. This is the fantastic feature in thispieces.com. So we have connected many times. Sometimes the network has failed. And sometimes we worried that, it has stopped, but it has not stopped. Okay.
Sir, there is a question. There is any option to share this quiz link to through WhatsApp?
Okay. So, one second, please.
Is there any option to share this quiz link through WhatsApp?
Yeah, you can. Yes, I will give a demo. Yes, WhatsApp mode. This is a good question. Because we are organizing a quiz means we have to create code first. We have to create code. Okay. We have to create code. After they display the code by the website, you just copy the code and post it to WhatsApp page, WhatsApp students, WhatsApp group. So by just the students can see the code and they can enter the code into the mobile screen, they can start. But one thing is you have to ensure that you should keep ready at the time of students. So you can ask the students to participate in the quiz by 11 a.m. You just post a message. Okay, at the time of 11 a.m. you can create a code and you can post it the code to WhatsApp group, students WhatsApp group. By seeing this WhatsApp code, WhatsApp with the play code, they can enter into their mobile or laptop, they can join. So once the students are joining, you can click start. So you can make the students connect in this platform. So this way you can organize this. No need to go for any other. Yes.
Sir, another question.
Yes, sir.
Proceed. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Please tell me, sir.
Sir, when you were conducting national level quiz competition,
yes, sir.
So, is it necessary first to create a WhatsApp group?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Then
sir.
Only it would be easier for us,
yes,
to
sir.
Send the code.
Yes, sir.
Right, sir.
Sir, I will guide you, sir. First of all, you wish to conduct a national level quiz competition. You are creating a brochure. In that brochure itself, you have to create Google form. Okay. So Google form. In the Google form, you just include the WhatsApp group. First, you have to create a WhatsApp group. In that, you can paste the WhatsApp group in the Google form itself. So while filling out the Google form, they can click the WhatsApp group, they can join. Okay, so they can easily join in the WhatsApp group. Okay. So no need to save the contact in your mobile phone and you can create a WhatsApp group. You just copy the create a WhatsApp group link and paste it in the Google form. In Google form itself,
so even in Google form, you mean that WhatsApp link needs to be, because that I am unaware of that, how to make that number to get into link with WhatsApp.
Okay,
for example, I am visiting your number in Google form, so you
yes,
are filling your number,
yes,
but
sir.
How it gets connected with our WhatsApp?
If time permits, let me do a demo, sir.
Sir, for us, we are very happy to learn many things from you, sir. You are doing wonderful. All the days, we are enjoying.
Yes, sir. Please, let me do some demo, sir.
We are very thankful to you if you do that, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir. I will do a demo. First, you have to go for a Google Drive in your account.
Yes. Okay.
Internet is very slow, sir. Please wait for some. Yes. So I can go for Google Drive. So I already created many Google forms, like personal business and online courses.
The screen is not
visible, sir. Oh, wait for a second.
Sir, meanwhile, can you explain about
is it visible, sir?
That math option.
Now it is visible.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Sir, let me finish this question, sir. Please wait for some time, sir. Okay, sir.
Yeah. Okay.
So in Google Drive, there is a Google form. So yesterday we have created, we have planned to conduct national level online quiz, sir. So I have created this Google form. Tomorrow we are going to conduct this national level quiz, guys, sir. So I have created, sir, for your doubt. So the other call the first, I have created this Google form. National level online quiz on social sciences. For BH students, pedagogical students, they can participate. So I created all these things, name and all, name of the institution. Okay.
WhatsApp number is there.
Yes, WhatsApp number, the participant's mobile number, and I will show that. See the below, sir. Can you see here? Use the following link and join in the WhatsApp group.
Yes.
Use the following link and join WhatsApp group. So while filling the form, so we can paste it here. Okay, sir. So first you have to create WhatsApp group. So you just copy the WhatsApp group. Once you create the WhatsApp group, just paste it here, sir. Paste it here and put enter.
That's so, group link.
This is you are creating. So I will demo. I will give a demo. If you are filling this form, it will give you a blue link, sir. If you click this link, it will be open in your mobile phone. So you can fill, you can join, just to click join. Okay. So I will, for demo purpose, I share this link, sir. Please, you can join in this WhatsApp group, sir. Okay, sir. But just join WhatsApp group and you can left up of the group for your confirmation. So similarly, you can, I have created 3 WhatsApp groups, sir. Because the PGQSS allows 500 participants. So each WhatsApp group has maximum participants limit is 257. Okay, so we allow the 3 groups. For example, 750 participants will be accommodated. So first come, first serve basis. So if participants comes, if you reach 500 participants, we can start the quiz. Okay, sir. So these are the 3 WhatsApp links I have pasted here. So once the participants are filling this form, they can join in any one of the WhatsApp group. Any one of the WhatsApp groups. Right. Similarly, we can organize quizzes. So tomorrow we are going to organize this quiz at 11 a.m. Similar and simultaneously it will be conducted tomorrow. So far you can see the responses, sir. 566. So far 566 participants were registered. So they have under 3 WhatsApp group. So we can post any information in that WhatsApp group. We can match the students by assemble at 11 a.m. So we will generate a code and we will post the code to the WhatsApp group. And by seeing this WhatsApp code, they can type it and we will give a time. So 11 to 11:30 is the registration time or 11:15 it will be started. We will send the message. The quiz starts. So they will start. So after ending the results, we will display the. Yes. Okay. I hope you have understood the scope. You have got the particular answer, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. This is the way you can organize the quiz.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Any other questions? Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. Any other questions? Any other questions from participants? Participants, if you have any questions, please ask me. Last. You have any questions, sir? Ajinkumar sir.
Yes sir, holding.
Is there any questions from chat box, sir?
There is no question, sir. Previously someone participant asked how can we use that option math link and timing. That is also we didn't explain that, so that's why they are asking.
Timing and the math link.
Yeah,
timing. For each question,
you get math option for mathematical formulas.
Okay. Wait for a second. Let me show this. I will demonstrate. You can while adding a framing your questions. In questions option, you can see the right corner. There is the odd image and the math options. But if there is any derivation, for example, dx by dt, or summation, or any other symbols, there will be more symbols in that. For example, click image. Similarly, you can click math options. You will find many number of tools. So you can just click it. You can add it. So for this will create a math questions regarding a this timing. Timing you have to set for each question. For if the question is very long, you can separately fix time for example, commonly you can set for 30 seconds. Otherwise, you can set timing. It depends upon the questions long. Okay. So for example, 45 questions, 45 seconds, or 15 seconds, you can set timing for the individual questions. For overall questions, you can just give a time for students. 15 minutes the time duration you have to attend this piece. So overall, for example, we have attended 15 questions now. So for 15 questions, we have given time 10 minutes. So within 10 minutes, you should finish this piece. And the teacher has to cancel over whether the time is over. You just go and end the game. So the time will be over. So you can get the results. Okay. I think you just. You got it.
Okay, sir. Fine.
Thank you. Any other questions? Shall we wind up?
Is there any other doubt? Shall we wind up? Okay, sir. I thought participants are joyfully enjoyed our session. So it is very informative and definitely. I thought I will assure that the participants will conduct the quiz for their students.
Thank you very much, participants. Thank you, participants, for your cooperation. Sometimes there will be a network problem, so you kindly cooperated with us. So today's assignment is, I will post the assignment today. Okay, so you have to create questions. You have to create 10 questions. You have to create 10 questions on your subject, and you have to copy the particular link. Okay, particular link. Just paste the particular link in a Google form. Okay, I will create a Google form. I will send it later. You can create an assignment. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you, participants, for your kind cooperation. Hope you have enjoyed this particular session. Thank you. Thank you, Rajkumar sir.
Now, wind up, Monica.
Thank you.